Emerson Innovation Center Flow Lab in Marshalltown, Iowa, where we're going to learn about a solution for cavitation. Now, leading us to that discussion today is Mike Hoime from Emerson. Welcome, Mike.
Thanks for having me.
Now, what are you going to be showing us today?
I'm going to show you the Fisher Cavitrol Hex Anti-Cavitation Trim.
And what is it?
It's Emerson's new solution to the problem of cavitation in process pipelines.
What is cavitation?
Well, Anna, cavitation happens when a liquid encounters a restriction that causes the fluid velocity to increase and the pressure to decrease. When the velocity reaches its maximum and the pressure reaches its minimum, it's called the vena contracta. If the pressure drops below the vapor pressure of the fluid, bubbles can form in the liquid. As the pressure recovers downstream from the vena contracta, the increased pressure causes those bubbles to implode. The imploding bubbles cause shockwaves in the fluid that create noise, vibration, and can cause severe damage to the pipeline and devices like pumps and valves within the pipeline. A fluid that's cavitating sounds a lot like gravel flowing through a pipeline.
Oh, sure. And what are people using now?
Well, one common approach is to use very hard materials that can better stand up to cavitation damage. Another is to use an anti-cavitation trim in a globe-style valve.
And what are some of the challenges to those current solutions?
So, if the harder material approach is being used, the noise and vibration is still present, which can be an issue in some cases. Also, harder materials tend to be more expensive, and they may be more difficult to meet those corrosion resistance requirements of the process fluid. Anti-cavitation globe valves are very effective at addressing cavitation, but the trade-off is that they tend to be very expensive, and they have lower flow capacities compared to an equivalent size of rotary valve.
Now, how is this better?
So the Cavitrol Hex allows us to address cavitation in a rotary valve that has a higher flow capacity as well as a lower purchase cost. The Cavitrol Hex can be added to an already installed Fisher V-ball or Fisher CB500 with very minimal modification to the valve and no piping changes necessary. So if you have a process that's cavitating, the Cavitrol Hex can be added on without needing to buy a whole new valve. The passages in the Cavitrol Hex are larger than many older anti-cavitation designs, so plugging of the passages isn't a concern that it can be in other solutions.
Well, how is it possible now?
So thanks to new additive manufacturing capabilities, we're able to create this array that isn't possible with conventional manufacturing techniques.
And how does it work?
So the best way to stop cavitation damage, noise, and vibration is to stop cavitation from happening in the first place. So the Cavitrol Hex helps control the pressure drop that allows bubbles to form in many cases. There are still times when cavitation can be reduced, but not completely prevented. In these cases, the array is designed to direct any bubbles that form into the middle of the pipeline and into smaller jets. This way, when they collapse, the shock waves are away from the pipe walls and are greatly dampened by the process fluid.
Now, can you show us an action?
I'd be happy to. Here is a test valve that we have set up to cavitate for demonstration purposes without the Cavitrol Hex. And here's that same valve under the same process conditions with the Cavitrol Hex installed.
Now, what are some typical applications for the Cavitrol Hex?
So the Cavitrol Hex is used in liquid service, like high pressure water, liquid natural gas, or oil. So we're seeing the Cavitrol Hex being installed in places where users have installed valves and they're experiencing cavitation due to changing their process conditions over time, or in some cases where the limitations of other anti-cavitation products weren't acceptable. So they had to replace their valves on a regular basis as a way of dealing with cavitation damage that they simply couldn't prevent at the time.
Mike, thank you so much. Where should people go to find out more information?
If they'd like to learn more, they can contact their local sales representative or go to emerson.com and search Cavitrol Hex.
Mike, thank you again for your time. And be sure to check out more demos as part of the virtual Emerson Exchange.